Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Implementing the rules that we've just learned in the fifth lesson. Sa'id says, أَكِتَابُ مُحَمَّدٍ هَذَا يَا يَاسِرُ. So basically in this one line, you've pretty much got everything that we've learned in this lesson. We learned this before, it means is. كِتَابُ مُحَمَّدٍ. Kitabu Muhammadin, we learned in this lesson that this is mudaf and mudaf ilayh. Mudaf, kitab, Muhammadin, mudaf ilayh. And we see that kitabu, it does not have tanween, it has only one dhamma. And Muhammadin, it has kasra. So this is mudaf and mudaf ilayh. And also we read that after a ya, the name will get one dhamma. The thing that you're calling out to, it will get one dhamma. So basically we got everything in this one line. So the translation would be, is this Muhammad's book, O Yasir? Is this Muhammad's book, O Yasir? Yasir says, La, hadha kitabu Hamidin. No, this is Hamid's book. So you see again, mudaf and mudaf ilayh over here. Sa'id, ayna kitabu Muhammadin? Where is Muhammad's book? Yasir, huwa ala al-maktabi hunaka. It is on the desk over there. Hunaka, over there. Sa'id says, ayna daftaru Ammarin? Where is Ammar's notebook? Yasir, huwa ala maktabil mudarrisi. It's on the teacher's desk. Sa'id says, qalamu man hadha ya Ali? Whose pen is this, O Ali? Ali Yun says, هذا قلم المدرس. This is the teacher's pen. So again, you have an example of مضاف and مضاف إليه, and مدرس has a كسرة. Sa'id says, أين حقيبة المدرس? Where is the teacher's briefcase? Ali says, هي تحت المكتب. So you find that هي is used for feminine things. And how do you know it's feminine? Because of this round ta over here. So, in the response to the question, he said, Hiya taht al-maktabi. Tamarin. Ajib anil as'ilatil atiya. Respond to the following questions. Aina kitabu Muhammadin? Where is Muhammad's book? Aina kitabu Ammarin? Where is Ammar's book? And again, all of the answers are above. So you can just look up and write the answers down. Aina haqibatul mudarris? Where is the briefcase of the teacher? The next lesson. Adif al-kalimat al-ula ila thaniya. What that means is that you have two words here, two nouns. What you're going to do is, you're supposed to make one mudaf and the second mudaf ilayh. So the first one becomes mudaf, the second becomes mudaf ilayh. So, kitabu Muhammadin, qalamu Hamidin, baytu Abbasin, ghurfatu Aliyin. This is in the case where the mudaf ilayh does not have alif lam, but in this case, you have alif lam on the nouns. So, maktabul mudarrisi. مفتاح البيت دكان التاجر بيت المهندس and so on and so forth. It is pretty self-explanatory. You should be able to do it by yourself. So please go ahead and do that. In this exercise, اقرأ واكتب مع ضبط أواخر الكلمات. Read and write. And in addition to doing that, put the haraka at the end of the words. Now we've learned already that the haraka on the mudaf ilayh is going to have kasra. So basically, this is what you're going to be focusing on. Babul madrasati, the school door. Himarul rajuli, the donkey of the man. Baytu Hamidin, Hamid's house. Sayyaratul mudiri, the principal's car. Mindilu Ammarin, Ammar's handkerchief. Ismu Talibi, the student's name. Baytullahi, Allah's house. Fi kitabillahi, in the book of Allah. So here you have fi, and because of fi, the mudaf, it took a kasra. And Allahi, it took a kasra because it's mudaf ilayh. Min baytil mudarrisi, from the teacher's house. The same thing applies over here. Ala maktabil mudiri, on the principal's desk. Iqra, read. Ayna baytul mudarris, huwa ba'idun. Where is the teacher's house? It is far. Al-Qur'anu kitabullahi, the Qur'an is the book of Allah. Al-Ka'batu baytullahi, the Ka'ba is the house of Allah. Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullahi. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Prophet of Allah. خرج المدرس من غرفة المدير. The teacher left from the room of the principal. هذا بيت حامد وذلك بيت خالد. This is Hamid's house and that is Khalid's house. ابن عمار طالب وابن ياسر تاجر. Ammar's son is a student and Yasir's son is a merchant. Now, look at the top of this alif or hamza. Technically, remember this point that whenever you have a hamza, whenever you have a shape of an alif, but it has a haraka on it, whether that haraka is fatha, dhamma, or kasra, zabr, zair, or pesh, that alif is in fact a hamza. Okay? It's not an alif, it's a hamza. As for qala, the empty alif, that is actually an alif. Okay, so technically speaking, if any alif has a haraka on it, then that is in fact a hamza. So on top of this hamza, you see a little sad, and I mentioned this before, that this indicates that this is a hamzatul wasl, and you're supposed to join it, like in this case, wabnu yasirin, ibnu ammarin talibun, wabnu yasirin tajirun, baytul mudarrisi ba'idun, wa baytul tajiri qaribun. The teacher's house is far and the merchant's house is close. هذا مفتاح السيارة. This is the key of the car. أين مفتاح البيت? Where is the house key? من أنت يا ولد? Who are you, O ولد? O boy. أنا ابن عباس. I am Abbas's son. وابن من هو? And whose son is that? هو ابن خالد. He is Khalid's son. أين مسجد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم? هو في المدينة المنورة. Where is the Masjid of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? It is in مدينة المنورة. بنت حامد في المدرسة وبنت محمد في الجامعة. Hamid's daughter is in school and Muhammad's daughter is in the university. اسم المدرس سعيد واسم المهندس خالد. The teacher's name is Sa'id and the engineer's name is Khalid. عم الطالب غني. The student's uncle is rich. باب المسجد مفتوح وباب المدرسة مغلق. The masjid's door is open and the school's door is closed. خال حامد فقير. Hamid's maternal uncle is poor. سيارة عباس في الشارع. Abbas's car is in the street. ابن من أنت? Whose son are you? أنا ابن المدرس. أين الكلب? هو تحت السيارة. Where is the dog? It is underneath the car. In the next exercise, what you are doing is you're putting appropriate words in the blank spaces. So you would find what the meanings are and just put a word there which is appropriate. For example, the first one, babul bayti mughlaqun. What would be locked is the door of the house is locked. Number two, ayna miftahu sayyarati. Where is the car key? Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulu Allahi, Rasulullahi, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the Prophet of Allah. And so on and so forth. You can do the rest by yourself. I think it's pretty self-explanatory. Shouldn't be too difficult to do. Now, in the next one, it's a little bit complicated, but remember the rules that we've mentioned. صحح التركيبات التالية. Correct the following تركيبات, meaning sentences. القلم الطالبي. Remember that the mudaf does not take alif lam. So therefore, al-qalam would be wrong. So, qalam al-talibi. Babu al-sayyaratu. Mudaf ilayh is supposed to have a kasra. So therefore, al-sayyaratu would be wrong. It's supposed to be babu al-sayyarati. Bintu hamidun. Same thing here. It's supposed to be hamidim. Ar-rasulullahi. Mudaf, not supposed to take alif lam. Ismul waladi. So this is supposed to have a kasra. Ibnul mudarrisi. It's supposed to be ibnu al mudarrisi. Ibnul, not ibnun al mudarrisi. Muhammadun ya Muhammadu. Ustadun ya Ustadu. Khalidun ya Khalidu. Waladun ya Waladu. So in this we learn that whenever you have harful nida, it's only going to get one dhamma. And basically, you can do the same here, that where there is a harful nida, meaning ya, the word ya is being used to call somebody, then the following noun, it only has one dhamma. And if there is no harful nida, then the noun will get two dhammas. The next exercise, it says, اقرأ المثال الآتي ثم كون أسئلة مثله مشيرا إلى الصور التالية. Look at the first example, and then you make the examples according to the example that is given. كتاب من هذا؟ قلم من هذا؟ قميص من هذا؟ بيت من هذا؟ سرير من هذا؟ The word ism. Ismul waladi Muhammadun wasmul binti Zainabu. The boy's name is Muhammad and the girl's name is Zainab. Ismul mudarrisi Hamidun. Masmul mudiri. The teacher's name is Hamid. What is the principal's name? Ibnun. Ibnu Khalidin fil madrasati wa ibnu Hamidin fil jami'ati. Khalid's son is in the school and Hamid's son is in the university. Ibn al-Mudarrisi fil fasli. The teacher's son is in the classroom. Ayn ibn al-Mudiri. Where is the principal's son? In this lesson, what you're going to do is اقرأ ما يلي مراعياً قواعد نطق حمزة الوصل. Read the following sentences, keeping in mind the recitation, the correct recitation of Hamzatul Wasl. So we mentioned already, Ibnu Wabnu. Ibnu Muhammadin fil Iraq, Wabnu Hamidin fil Hind. Kharajabnu Tabibi min al Bayti. Kharajabnu Tabibi min al Bayti. Zahababnu Tajir. Zahababnu Tajiri ila Suqi. The merchant's son went to the market. اسم المهندس فيصل واسم الطبيب مسعود. The merchant's name is Faisal and the doctor's name is Mas'ud. ما اسم الرجل? What is the man's name? ابن من أنت? Whose son are you? أنا ابن الوزير. I'm the minister's son. And we've already discussed in the previous lesson the meanings of the new words. And here we have an example of مضاف and مضاف إليه. سيارة المدرسي. سيارة is مضاف. المدرسي is مضاف إليه.